Phyton. Disturbance in homeostasis and disturbance in hemodynamics. And today we'll talk about the disturbance. Homeostasis. The mechanism by which the constancy of the internal environment is maintained and ensured. Homeostasis of blood supply. Can you hear me properly? Tell me, please.
Yes, doctor.
Yes, ma'am.
Homeostasis of blood supply consists of the transport and exchange function. It's implemented by blood and lymph circulation. They are closely connected to each other. You know this very well. The state of the system depends on following conditions like osmotic and oncotic pressure, fluid and electrolyte balance, hormone level, particularly renin, angiotensin, aldosterone system, and alters metabolism or different kinds of damage to cell and tissue. I will continue, yes.
Okay.
Ilhami today is absent.
Maybe, I think so.
Hemodynamics are principles of blood flow. Normal circulatory function requires uninterrupted flow of blood from the left ventricle to the farthest capillaries in the body and the return of blood from systemic capillary network into the right ventricle to the farthest pulmonary capillaries and back to the left atrium, which is the normal.
Doctor, please, 1 minute. Okay, thank you.
The regimen of blood flow are considered under two broad headings. Disturbance in volume of the circulating blood, it is the hyperemia, congestion, or hemorrhage and shock, and circulatory disturbance of obstructive nature, for example, thrombosis, embolism, ischemia, and infarction. And we will talk about each derangement. Continue, yes? Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Hyperemia and congestion. What is this? It's the increased volume of blood in an affected tissue or part tissue. It is differences between them. It's the same in definition. Yes, increase the volume of the blood. But hyperemia, also known as active hyperemia, it occurs due to arterial and arteriolar dilatation, which is produced an increased flow of blood into capillary bed. Input of blood increased in the capillary bed. For example, like in the dilation of the blood vessels in inflammatory process. And congestion, also known as passive congestion or venous congestion, it occurs due to reduced output of the blood flow, impaired venous drainage. For example, two different mechanisms. Active hyperemia, too much arterial blood is brought to an organ or tissue by dilated arterioles or capillaries through sympathetic neurogenic mechanisms or the release of vasoactive substances. Examples: inflammatory reaction, heat applied locally to a part, and increased physiological activity. Here, what you can see, hyperemia of the capillaries in the eye, redness. They show us redness blood because blood is oxygenated due to increased input of the blood in the region of the blood capillary bed. And in the microscopic picture, you can see alveoli from left side normal. Alveoli, normal in structure, and hyperemia of the intraalveolar capillaries and the edema of the alveoli edema and hyperemia of the blood capillaries, which are situated in the wall of alveoli. Hyperemic tissue is usually reddish and they have high temperature, characterized by visible vessels and pulsation and increased metabolism. Bacterial hyperemia of independent cause physiological has no pathology. Like the inflammatory reaction, yes? Hyperemia occurs due to action of the radioactive substances like histamine, increases dilatation of the blood vessel and increase the amount of the blood in the blood vessel. Excessive congestion occurs due to blood leaving an organ or part of organ is impaired venous due to impaired venous drainage. Grossly, you also involved tissue appear bluish red because of the poorly oxygenated venous blood. Microscopically, congestion looks like the hyperemia. Capillaries and veins are dilated and filled with blood. But reason is different, yes? Here, reduced output of the blood in hyperemia, increased input of the blood in hyperemia, oxygenated blood, that's why reddish tissue, here bluish red tissue due to poorly oxygenated venous blood. types of passive congestion, local and general or systemic passive congestion. Local congestion results from obstruction to venous outflow from an organ or part of the body. In systemic, we can see chronic generalized passive congestion of the lungs due to reduced left ventricle output and left-sided heart failure, or chronic passive congestion of the liver due to right-side heart failure. Next derangement is hemorrhage. What is hemorrhage? Presence of erythrocytes outside the blood vessel. The vessel may be physically damaged so that erythrocytes flow out through a break in the wall, also known as hemorrhage by erection. Or erythrocytes may pass through an intact vascular wall by a process called as diapedesis, also known as hemorrhage by diapedesis. Diapedesis, you know, occurs due to permeability of the blood vessels or the permeability of the endothelium, this transmigration of blood cells, like in neutrophils. Transmigration in inflammatory reaction, this process also occurs with erythrocytes, due to changes in the permeability and due to changes in hydrostatic pressure in the blood flow. Here you can see intracerebral bleeding. Hemorrhage. Or, for example, bleeding of gastric ulcer.
Doctor? Please, can you return the first photo?
Continue.
Okay, doctor, thank you.
Or hemorrhage due to bleeding, due to gastric ulcer. So you can see mucus membrane, eroded artery, and fibrous scar tissue. Bleeding occurred due to ulcer of the gastric mucosa. There are different terms which name the hemorrhage, different namings of hemorrhage. First one is PCI. I don't know how it is pronounced because it's very difficult. PCI is a small red or purple spot caused by bleeding into skin. Next, ecchymosis are large intravasations of blood into the skin and mucous membrane. Purpuras are small areas of hemorrhage up to 1 centimeter into the skin and mucous membrane. Hematoras is an accumulation of blood within the pleural cavity. Hemopericardium is an accumulation of blood in the pericardial sac of the heart. Continue, yes?
1 minute. Okay, thank you.
Next, epistaxis is the bleeding from the nose. Hemoptysis is the coughing up of blood. Enteroregia is the bleeding of intestinal tract. Mesoregia is the acyclic uterine bleeding. And hematuria is the presence of RBCs in the urine. Again, two mechanisms due to damage of the blood vessel or due to the epididymis. Leakage of RBCs. Here you can see kidneys, normal and abnormal. This potential hemorrhage due to herpes virus infection on kidney. So this one it can move in the brain. Here you can see like zebra striping, yes, structure, the hyperemia and hemorrhage in longitudinal folds of the colon shows us zebra striping appearance. Significance of hemorrhage depends on the volume of blood loss, the rate of blood loss, and the site of hemorrhage. Next derangement is shock. Peripheral circulatory failure with pooling of the blood in the terminal circulatory bed in small capillaries. The fundamental disturbance is that blood volume is too small to fill the vascular system, resulting in a fall of blood pressure and cell damage due to anoxia. Anoxia deficiency of oxygen. Kinds of shock are hypovolemic, septic, cardiogenic, and neurogenic, traumatic, and hypoadrenal. We'll talk about clinical signs of shock. Inconsistent and varied with the precipitating cause. Animals are usually inactive and responsive to external stimuli. Muscle weakness is prominent and there is pallor or coolness of the skin. Body temperature is subnormal and the heart rate is increased in most types of shock, but it may be slow and irregular. And depression of renal function and urine production of hemoglobin. Signs of shock, hypovolemic, because due to loss of blood volume. Hemorrhage, trauma, loss of fluids and burns, for example. Septic shock, septicemia or an overwhelming infection with gram-negative or gram-positive organisms. Peripheral dilatation of the capillary bed, which subsequently lead to shock. Cardiogenic shock, also known as cardiac shock, was due to pump failure, subsequent to sudden decrease in cardiac output. Neurogenic shock, a shock state mediated by the nervous system, which induces peripheral dilatation, dilatation of the capillary bed. It occurs in animals with severe fright, pain, and trauma, without hemorrhage. The genesis of shock occurs, first of all, that variant due to reduced effective circulating blood volume, then maybe due to reduced supply of oxygen to the cells and tissues with the resultant anoxia, and inflammatory mediators and toxins released from shock-induced cellular injury can activate formation of shock condition in the body. Circulatory disturbances of obstructive nature. Ischemia. The local anemia or a deficiency of arterial blood to a portion of an organ or part of organ. The chief causes of ischemia are external pressure upon an artery, narrowing of the lumen of an artery, or thrombosis. Effects of ischemia. No effects on tissue if collateral channels develop adequately, the effect of ischemia fails to occur. Functional disturbances when collateral channels are able to supply blood during normal activity, but the supply is not adequate to withstand the effects of exertion. Example is angina pectoris. And cellular changes, multi-cloudy swelling, fatty changes, ischemic atrophy, replacement fibrosis, and sudden death causes myocardial and cerebral infarction. Leukemia can be acute or chronic. Acute ischemia is sudden complete arterial occlusion. In chronic, radial incomplete arterial occlusion. In acute, causes are thrombus or embolus. Severe arterial spasm. Surgical gauge of artery. In chronic, causes, for example, atherosclerosis or arteritis or artery compression by tumor, for example. Next, thrombosis. Thrombosis, you know, is the formation of a clot from elements of the circulating blood within the vascular system during life. It may decrease or obstruct vascular flow, causing ischemic hypoxic injury to cells, tissues, and organs. May become dislodged or fragmented to create emboli. Embolus is an intravascular mass carried in the bloodstream to some site remote from its origin. The pathologic state resulting in formation of solid compact mass inside uninjured or injured blood vessel. Here you can see caudal vena cava thrombosis formation. Red thrombosis. Or thrombosis under microscope. Mechanism of formation of the blood thrombus. It depends on three components: endothelium, platelets, and coagulation cascade. The initial point of thrombosis is endothelial damage, and the blood clot is formed by interaction of thrombocytes, damaged endothelial cells, and blood clotting system. It activates coagulation cascade. stages of morphogenesis of thrombus. The whole agglutination of platelets. Which is mediated by factor E produced by endothelial cells. And coagulation of fibrinogen to fibrin formation occurs upon the activation of the blood clotting system. Agglutination of red blood cells and precipitation of plasma proteins. Morphology of thrombosis. Depending on the structure and appearance distinguish, there are some types of thrombus: white, red, mixed, and hyaline thrombi. White blood clot is made up of platelets, fibrin, and white blood cells. It is formed slowly with a rapid blood flow, usually in the arteries. Red blood clot is made up of platelets, fibrin, and red blood cells produced rapidly at low current levels, usually in veins. Mixed thrombus has a layered structure and colorful form. It contains elements of both white and red thrombus, usually formed in veins in the cavity of the aneurysm of the aorta and heart. Hyaline fibrin clot rarely contains fibrin. It has platelets, destroyed red blood cells, and precipitating plasma proteins. Reminiscent of hyaline formed in the microvasculature. here information of thrombus. There is a cause also known as search of trait. What is this? Three processes occur. Endothelial injury, then altered blood flow, and hypercoagulability. What does it mean? In endothelial injury, what does occur? No, there are some causes for the endothelial injury. You know, it may be inflammation or endocarditis, for example, ulcerated atherosclerotic plaque, hemodynamic stresses, like the hypertension, for example, or action of some endotoxins or radiation, etc. Main mechanism of action of the injured endothelial cells, they secret special activators for the adhesion, these effectors. They increase the adhesion of the platelets, increase the production of procoagulants like tissue factors, and decrease anticoagulant activity. It can lead to the coagulation of the blood, yes? And then altered blood flow. You know, there is normal linear blood flow. I explained you on the practical classes. And when cells carry through the blood vessels in the central part and plasma surrounds the cells and connect with the wall of the blood vessel. And when there is the stasis of the blood flow, it leads to disrupt laminar flow, bring platelets into contact with endothelial cells, decrease in flow clotting inhibitors and increase endothelial cell activation. And it is again lead to the production of the procoagulants. And hypercoagulability, what does it mean? Is there any alteration of coagulation pathway that predisposes to thrombosis? It may depend on hereditary diseases, hereditary spread in some states of the blood vessels. When decreased, for example, synthesis of antithrombin, increased number of platelets due to some genetic mutation. In the mixed thrombus, it has three parts, head, body, and tail. Head has a structure of white blood thromb, body actually mixed blood thromb, and tail a structure of red blood thromb. Head usually is attached to the endothelial lining of the vessel, which differs the thromb of the postmortem blood clot. In relation to the vessel lumen, thromb may be a blood parietal or occlusive. And growth of thrombus indicates by progressive thrombosis. It depends on duration of the mechanism of thrombosis. Depends on the severity of the stress. factors effective in thrombosis, injury to vascular endothelium, role of platelets, alteration in normal blood flow status, alterations in blood hypercoagulability and hypercoagulable state, thrombophilia, conditions having increased risk. I already explained about factors. Again, it's also known as this term, also known as Virchow's triad, includes injury, first factor, second one, role of platelets, no, alterations in normal blood flow, second one, and third one, hypercoagulability and different states, hypercoagulable states. Coagulation of blood or clotting is implemented by a cascade of enzymatic actions aimed at converting soluble plasma protein fibrinogen to insoluble fibrin. It occurs as a result of plasma coagulation factors. There is a special mechanism which is called as fibrinolysis. The system of destruction of blood coagulates and aggregates arising from the bloodstream is generated during the evolution, which is a mechanism to remove excess coagulates or microthrombosis, etc. It prevents the development and dissemination of thrombosis. Which changes occur in endothelium. There is endothelial injury. Due to produced anticoagulant protein, it allows easy sliding or blood along the inner surface of the vessel. normal prothrombotic activity is minimal. But when there is injury of endothelium, endothelial cells form coagulation factors 5, 8, 3, 12, and adhering protein fibronectin. These substances activate formation of the thrombus. Thrombocytes or platelets, how they react to the formation of thrombus after several damage of endothelial cells. There is formation of the platelet aggregate. It occurs on the basal membrane of the endothelium through successive three processes: adhesion, secretion, and aggregation. Adhesion. What does it mean? Adhesion of platelets to exposed collagen, which is mediated by factor 8. Platelets release now EDP. It leads to aggregation of more platelets. And the initial thrombus is formed now of platelets only. This pale can be washed out. But then platelets release thromboxane. It leads to platelet contraction and formation of thrombin from prothrombin. And then thrombin activates transformation of fibrinogen into fibrin, which deposit on platelet thrombus and increase deposit of platelets. And platelets now deposit in layers. And between these layers, there is deposition of fibrin with RBCs and white blood cells. Next, disorder, stasis, derangement, stasis, stoppage of the blood flow in the microvasculature, mainly in the capillaries, causes circulatory disorders associated with infection, intoxication, venous congestion, and shock. Mechanism of development. Sludge phenomenon, which is speaking of RBCs. White blood cells or platelets to each other and increase in plasma viscosity, resulting in difficulty in perfusion of blood through the vessels of the microvasculature. You remember, for example, in inflammation, when there is coming out of the fluid from the blood, it increases viscosity of the blood, and formed elements of the blood become concentrated. It leads to formation of aggregates of the RBCs, white blood cells, and platelets. We are sticking. But this process is very important in the transmigration of the neutrophils in the region of the injury, for example. Greatest danger is stasis in the capillaries of the brain. When the capillaries and venules dramatically expand, overflooded with red blood cells, which are sticked with each other in the form coin bunch, in brain matter develops edema. Prolonged stasis in the brain leads to the development of focal necrosis. Clinical scene seen as a brain coma. Here, for example, you can see stasis in the blood capillaries of the brain. Related blood capillaries with filled by RBCs. Arterial venous thrombus. Grossly thrombi are friable, mixture of red and gray in irregular layers, dull and attached to the endothelium. But there are some difference between types of the thrombus of arterial and venous. Arterial thrombus usually are dry, friable, gray masses composed of almost regularly arranged layers of platelets and fibrin, irregularly mixed with small amounts of darker red coagulated blood. Venous thrombus are red and gelatinous. Thrombosis in veins more is common because veins are thin walls, superficial, easily injured, and in veins blood flow is slow. These thrombi occlude lumen and easily embolize. The arterial thrombi usually occur over ruptured atherosclerotic plaques, less often at sites of other vascular disease or old-stage surgery. Naming of thrombi. First type, mural thrombi, are attached to the wall of the heart or blood vessel. Occluding thrombi are attached to the entire circumference of the vessel. Valvular thrombi are attached to the heart valve. Canalized thrombi occur when new blood channels form in an organized thrombus. Central thrombi. Next step. Thread of the bifurcation of blood vessels. Septic thrombi are those which contain bacteria. Aseptic thrombi are those that do not contain bacteria. thrombus may increase the size and by its enlargement eventually cause obstruction of some critical vessel, may give rise to emboli, may be removed by fibrinolytic action or become organized. The fate of thrombus. The table which shows us differences between thrombus and postmortem clot. In consistency, thrombus is dry and friable, postmortem clot moist and jelly-like. Surface of thrombus is granular and rough, and postmortem clot is smooth and glistening. Color of thrombus white or buff, postmortem clot intense red or yellow. Attachment in thrombus attached to vessel wall. Postmortem is not attached to vessel wall. Endothelium in thrombus damaged, injured. Postmortem clot undamaged. Composition of thrombus platelets primarily, fibrin primarily in postmortem clot. Rapidity of blood flow and thrombus formed in flowing stream of blood. Postmortem clot formed in stagnant column of blood. Манси. Манси. Okay, we will not continue our lecture. We will continue it on the next class.